The next speaker is Professor Aleksandra Korać-Grauvac from the University of Zagreb. She will speak about the family and family protection in Croatia. And she is, as I see, the first speaker whose contribution is within the book present here. Please, Professor Korać-Grauvac, you take the floor.
Thank you very much. Also, I'm very honored to be here and privileged to share experiences. And my duty and my idea is to talk a little bit about family law and family protection in Croatia, a little bit because it's impossible in 20 minutes to say everything because it would take more conference days for single person, not on, or for many presenters from each of our countries. So I will present just some highlighted topics which I found interested in this moment and for this purpose. Very often we family law academicians are asked to participate in demographic policy or in family policy. To be honest, demography is one of the most important topics from public point of view, and family is protected especially because of this goal. Because you'll see at the very end, politicians, I think, are not very very interested in family law because it is hot potato, we say. It's very difficult to enact new family act because it's highly confronted with different ideas and ideologies, especially in last decades. Politicians are not very keen of changing family legislation. And even in demographic policy, influence of family law is rather minor. I say usually, please don't waste my and your time. Family law is not important for demographic purposes. And we have to be honest. But of course, other family interdisciplinary supportive measures are much important. More important, and the only field of family law, as I find of greater importance, is regulation of alimony. It is the huge problem in every country, because I used to say, that my mother used to say, a woman can allow herself to have so many children as she alone can support. And this is rather pessimistic. Also, there is now changing role of fathers in our societies, but it is an old idea that is still present for many of single living mothers. Also, when we say single parent, it is not the same as before because of shared parental responsibility. But with parent living alone. How family law can influence family policy? That is another question, and I'm a very strong advocate in favor of family policy. What has happened during our last family policy? It was enacted in 2003. Proposals in the field of family law was that disputes concerning human rights should be under judicial competence rather than competence of social welfare office, because in that time, under the influence of jurisprudence of European Court for Human Rights, it was said that social welfare offices, administrative procedures, and administrative courts were not courts of full jurisdiction. So because of protection of procedural rights of family members, disputes were transferred to courts. In last 20 years, we are talking all the time about family courts. Now we have some family divisions, but the latest proposal in judicial reform should be that we should have family courts, and this would be improvement in a sense of family protection. Then, that time, it was stressed necessity to enact a separate legislation concerning family violence. Nowadays is self-understanding. The only struggle is should family violence be protected and not protected, but fought under minor demeanors law or by criminal law. So it depends which action is faster. Sorry, I don't know the right word, but we have criminal act, family violence as a criminal act, and also there are some courts, not criminal courts, but misdemeanor, yes, I used the right, thank you, misdemeanor courts, and in this way protection is faster, and also we have some protocols protecting family members and helping policy, courts and social welfare officers and also schools and other public institutions to cooperate faster. And this is a great improvement. Then family therapy was emphasized. Enabling modern legislation on medically assisted procreation, we have it right now, once amended, and I find it as a good regulation. Promotion of cooperation among bodies and institutions through different protocols, and some very good measure in a declaratory level, the act, the Family Act in 2007, enabled parents who doesn't and children who doesn't receive alimony to get some part of this alimony through a temporary by a social welfare office, and a parent who doesn't pay for alimony will be prosecuted ex officio, and and the state has right to versio to get this money back. But this alimony is not the whole, it's symbolic, I would say. It is about 70 euros to 90 euros, depending on the age of child. Symbolically, but these other kinds of repression are also okay. When we are talking about family law, our family laws are modeled by protected values in each of our country. In every country, there is a constitutional demand that the family shall enjoy special protection of state, and this regulation concerns, I tried to find out some of fields, marriage, cohabitation, non-marital union, same-sex partnership, especially because of children who may live in such partnerships, child-parent relationship, and family violence. Beside alimony. Talking about marriage, now heterosexuality of marriage is a constitutional value, a little bit forced, not a little bit forced by so-called, we call it a popular constitutional initiative since 2013. Because in that time, you know how it happened in some other constitutions, our representative body, our parliament wasn't very much against, were in favor of homosexual marriage, and there was an NGOs initiative that that was finalized by this constitutional provision that marriage is a living human union between a woman and a man. But no matter of this norm regulation, also we have a norm that marriage and legal relations in marriage, non-marital union, and the family shall be regulated by law. Concerning marriage, it's interesting that we are also under influence of global treaties, Convention of the Rights of the Person with Disabilities. We heard today about Polish constitutional ruling of Polish Constitutional Court. We have the right of a person with disability to marry. Even this person is deprived of legal capacity concerning personal status, namely also concluding marriage, if this person gets approval or consent of his or her guardian. We have still quite traditional approach to guardianship, and this is another question. So. This might be something new, and another interesting question is how the state would protect or promote family. That was with that we were talking about paternalistic approach or about a supportive approach. Till 2014, we had an obligation for state for social welfare office to help spouses to try to save the marriage, and this provision had some effects before. We have some scientific articles that some spouses gave up to divorce. But we don't know how long does it last? We have no longitudinal researches. So if somebody nowadays decides to divorce and we help him not to divorce, if this decision will be made later, we don't know this. But now this we left protective and paternalistic approach. The only goal is to help spouses to reach an agreement concerning their future relations. It's maybe more realistic, but I don't know if we ask children, I think they would like more the first approach. So it's the question if a marriage is social value or solely a private matter of individuals. These rights of children nowadays should protect mediation and mediation is obligatory but can't stop divorce. So at least a person, a spouse who want to initiate a divorce have to approach to a mediation if only one of them would like to divorce. So we can say there are different approaches in different legislative levels, different approaches on in constitution and later in legislation, but we can all, of course, discuss it. Concerning non-marital union, I will not read and I will not explain the whole slide because we don't have time, but I would like to say that if legal requirements are fulfilled, that non-marital spouses are cohabitating for 3 years, or they have a common child, or that is new, if their cohabitation has been followed by subsequent marriage. Then this union is considered to be a non-marital union. Why the third requirement? Because there was a case when a couple divorced. They lived less than 3 years before. In cohabitation, a child has been conceived, and a husband was a basketball player, and he signed a contract with NBA with a huge, of course, income. And when they divorced, her his a woman required the half of value of this contract. And then the Supreme Court said that they lived in non-marital union before. It was less than 3 years, a child has been conceived, and that this non-marital union was followed by stronger legal relationship. And this is quite interesting because it suddenly made him half half rich than he was before. It's really questionable, and reasoning was very short in this Supreme Court decision. After this, it is enacted this rule, and this is what we have now. Non-marital spouses are equal with effects of non-marital union to marriage, even in tax, if you can imagine. And some elder non-marital spouses are not very keen on this because their non-marital partner concurs to inheritance with their biological children, and because they can't dismiss it from inheritance, so it can be rather questionable sometimes. Same-sex partnership are introduced in legal system in 2007. And since 2014, we have registered partnership and informal partnership with almost same effects as marriage. So the notion marriage is safeguarded only for pure juridical reasons. It's interesting that that homosexual partner, same-sex from living in same-sex partnership, has even more rights than a stepfather or stepmother, because it is the act written for older adults, not for children, and it's interesting, but they have more rights than heterosexual step families. Child-parent relationship is we can divide in two phases: during family union, if there is one, or after dissolution of family union, or for parents who never lived in family union. During the existence of family union, it's important for family law to protect the right to respect private and family life of family members. There are always problem with state intervention and separation of children from family. There are public struggles if social welfare office or court separate children in sake to protect them. They don't understand why, and there are bitter reaction against this. And if they don't do this, and we had several scandals, and children are dying, we have to say in the last several years, then also there is a huge problem. Also, we can talk about right of parents to freely decide on children's education. We have some discussions on sexual education and so-called civil education because of some values that some traditional viewed parents oppose. And after dissolution of family union, of course, it's very important parental responsibility and the regulation of parental responsibility. And we had a huge change in approach. Till 2014 and 15, we had always shared parental responsibility. After 2015, even a parent who doesn't live with a child and has shared parental responsibility has limited rights to influence upbringing and representation of his or her child. Rights of the child and child-friendly justice, a very modern topic. We had a big problem because we introduced a special representative of the child in 2014 and employed eight lawyers with bar exam for the whole Croatia. They had 4,000 or 5,000 cases a year, eight lawyers in four cities, having to cover a circle of 200 kilometers with one car. So we had good wishes, but without human and financial resources. Okay, I have my. So now this is a little bit better, but not enough. And we are in huge problem because children's procedural rights according to law are breached in almost every case because these special representatives, they are not enough lawyers, don't have time to talk with each child who is in dispute, in a court dispute with parents, including divorces who are solved in dispute, like a dispute, and also adults who are deprived of the legal capacity. So this is a huge problem. So as a conclusion, as I have a couple of seconds, my opinion, my personal opinion, that family law doesn't need revolution, we need evolution. We need to, we had the problem with implementation of European ideas in Croatia. And these ideas are not followed by knowledge and readiness to follow these new rules. It's always the problem, especially in family law, and also according to people who have to addressates of these legal rules. Uncritical implementation of solutions from other legal models sometimes does not work well. We had problem, for example, good example of the rights with the rights of the child. We had a huge fight to persuade, especially church and traditional wings, that rights of the child are not bombed in family. They need to, these rights have to promote quality of family life. And we managed to do this. Now it is not considered like this. But in some cases, this does not work well. I know you also had problem with guardianship, for example. New instruments have to be sufficiently supported by human and final resources. We have also new phenomena under influence of human rights doctrine. We have courts creating policy, even contralegal. For example, we have court decisions, not constitutional court, but administrative court decisions, ruling contralegal. For example, concerning rights of same-sex partners to foster children. This is a new phenomenon. I like common law system, but you need to have sufficient sufficient reasoning in these rulings. Elderly are still underprotected. We talk about family. Please do not forget elderly members of family because they really need support and they are very often exposed to very unfamiliar and not lovable actions of their young, of their children and their and other members of family. And I have to say again, we are here not politicians, but politicians are not really interested in promoting family protection in Croatia. They are afraid of changing family. They are family regulation, they are afraid of reasoning. So it's better all don't make any changes. It's good like it goes. We don't want to intervene here. So Also, there is no serious investment in family judiciary system and system of social welfare. But I think this is the problem of many of our countries because it's the problem, of course, of budget and everything, not mentioning social changes we witnessed last years, and this make everything much difficult. So thank you for your attention. Thank you for this minute or two longer. This is what I wanted to share with you.